All right, the car's in third gear, the throttle is wide open, and this turbo is struggling to put out its full amount of power.
Sweden, we have a problem.
Don't let the throaty exhaust note fool you. The turbo in this 1994 Saab 900 Commemorative Edition is not putting out full power. Let's follow the procedure in the Bentley manual and see if we can figure out what's going on. Step one is disconnecting the APC solenoid valve. It plays a key role in regulating boost pressure. With the solenoid disconnected, the turbo should be limited to putting out what's called base boost. We're looking for about 5.8 pounds per square inch. To get an accurate reading, connect a vacuum gauge to one of the ports on the intake manifold and hit the road.
Your Saab turbo has a boost gauge, of course, but it's not a calibrated gauge, so Bentley recommends this procedure. You connect your boost gauge, as I've shown you, and then you keep the car at 3,000 RPM in third gear with your foot on the floor, throttle wide open, and then hold the brakes. You want to hold the car at 3,000 RPM. The boost gauge will stabilize and give you an accurate base boost reading.
Instead of 5.8 pounds of boost pressure, this car is struggling to generate just 1 pound. I don't see any signs that the turbo is worn or defective, so we're going to dig a little deeper into the turbo system and how it's controlled. Saab drew on its heritage as an aircraft manufacturer to pioneer turbocharging in everyday passenger cars. Saab's magic is the APC, Automatic Performance Control System. The brilliance of this system is it lets you use any octane fuel available and still crank out maximum power safely. This APC box on the left front fender controls the solenoid valve. It opens the wastegate to reduce boost pressure when sensors warn that the engine is nearing its danger zone. Think of the wastegate as kind of like holding your thumb on the end of a garden hose. The APC solenoid controls the thumb, keeping it closed until the boost pressure reaches a maximum safe level. When a knock sensor bolted to the engine detects ping, premature detonation, the solenoid valve diverts some of the pressure and opens the wastegate to bleed down the boost pressure to base boost level. Now, since my base boost was low, I used this adjustment to shorten the rod from the wastegate actuator to the actual wastegate device, and this holds the wastegate closed more tightly, helping it to build boost pressure. Let's see if that generates more boost. We're back on the road, full throttle, foot on the brake to hold 3,000 RPMs. We've doubled the boost pressure to about 2 pounds, but not the 5.8 we're looking for. Now let's do the test that really matters and determine the turbo's maximum output. Now, some guys run more than 20 pounds of boost in their cars, but I'll be happy with the factory setting of about 12 for now. And for this test, we'll disconnect this hose from the APC solenoid valve leading to the wastegate actuator. So that takes the wastegate out of the picture.
So this is a test with no protection whatsoever for the turbo. The APC wastegate line is disconnected, so we should be getting all the turbo can output. Let's see how this goes. Here we go. Full throttle from dead stop. Oh, big difference. I don't know what you were seeing, but I was seeing the car's internal boost gauge bouncing into the red before it felt like the fuel shutoff system was coming into play.
This tells me the turbo is healthy. It's got the guts. It can reach maximum pressure. Now we're going to reconnect the APC system and see what happens.
Yeah, clearly with all the safeguards reattached, the engine's just not putting out that full 12 pounds of boost that I'd like to see.
We collected some good data today. We know now that the turbo is capable of putting out its full amount of power, but something is causing the APC to kick in before then and limit the boost. Love to hear your suggestions in the comments. I'll keep after it. And in the meantime, get out in the garage and get yourselves dirty, all right?